Yo, what it do, YouTube? It's your boy Coach Talk. We're back with another video. Today, we're discussing the interview that just went down on the Pat McAfee show. If you guys missed it, I suggest you subscribe to that channel. Also, check it out. Man, it was a good interview. Spoke about a lot of things, and this is going to be pretty interesting when you think about it. But on to the breakdown, right? T.Y. Hilton pretty much broke down why he decided to return to Indianapolis. He took a huge pay cut, and he almost went to Baltimore. He almost went to the Baltimore Ravens. The fact to even think about that is crazy because we do play them next year, man. It's a crazy process to think about. I mentioned this plenty of times, man. It's a business. You know, these contract deals, this free agency is all about business. You know, it's personal feelings aside when it comes down to making deals, man. So, you know, T.Y. really explained the real process of what brought him back to Indianapolis. He mentioned God, Reggie Wayne, and Jim Irsay. And that is insane to think about because he came down to it. He said he made a deal. He was discussing a deal with Chris Ballard, and they weren't seeing eye to eye, so he hung up the phone. So Chris Ballard really almost made us lose a wide receiver in T.Y. Hilton, which is crazy to think. So after he hung up the phone with Chris Ballard, he said Jim Irsay texted him and discussed what deal he wanted. And they actually agreed to terms. And that's what brought him back to Indianapolis. That's pretty crazy to think that, you know, Ballard didn't come eye to eye with T.Y. Hilton. He probably undervalued him. So he was maybe looking for him to take a bigger pay cut than what he originally signed with Irsay. And, you know, then Irsay texted him, got to a deal that T.Y. could use for a one-year deal, which is crazy. A one-year deal T.Y. wanted. And he took a pay cut anyway to come back to Indianapolis instead of going to Baltimore. I'm thinking that's just wild, man. It really is wild. This is no slander to Chris Ballard at all because I still love Ballard at the end of the day. He's a hard guy to get around when it comes to making deals. So it's expected. But, you know, the fact that Irsay stepped in and got T.Y. to return instead of going to Baltimore is just a huge bonus for me, in my opinion. Him in Baltimore just would have been crazy. And for the fact, another thing added, T.Y. mentioned that he wanted a 1 to 2 year deal. It's not 2 to 3 that some of you guys in the comment section was mentioning. You guys mentioned crazy numbers and what he expected and all these things. It's like you guys don't know anything. You guys don't know anything. You guys are fans just like me. So we all have an opinion of what do you think the contract might be or what he's asking for. And the fact that he asked for a 1 to 2 year deal and Baltimore was looking to give him 3, like, I don't understand what you guys were thinking at that point. So, you know, I just thought that was funny to begin with, but, you know, 1 to 2 year deal is not bad. You know, he signed a 1 year, 10 mil to come back to Indianapolis. I'm so thankful for that. Shout out to Reggie Wayne, shout out to Jim Irsay. And then, you know, next year he's going to be a free agent again. You know, with the media contract the NFL just signed is a big bonus to these contracts that's going to happen in next year free agency. So I know people are going to get a lot of more money. So, you know, T.Y. is going to be in the market again. So we will see how that goes. And unfortunately, we'll see. We don't know what's going to happen at all. We really don't. But, you know, another person he mentioned is Andrew Luck. Andrew Luck texted him and he said congratulations and how proud he was. And that kind of made me shed a tear. I ain't gonna lie to you guys. That was really emotional. But the fact that, you know, Andrew still watches the game, still watches TV. He doesn't live under a rock for some people that might think that. So, you know, I thought that was pretty cool. But, you know, but it was good. It was a dope interview. I enjoyed every second of it. The fact that he got the deal done and the process that went down. He mentioned how T.Y. Hilton and Pat McAfee almost went to the same school. You know, how he turned out West Virginia. I just thought the whole interview process was just hilarious, man. But let me know your thoughts and the reactions of what you heard about what went down during these contract negotiations. Let me get your thoughts, whether they're positive or negative. But T.Y.'s home, baby. Let's go, Colts. We'll see y'all next year. And until next time, this is Coach Talk signing out. Peace.